So I'm here with Ollie Wilson, and we're talking about the pedestrianisation, I should say, of Madeira Drive. It was a temporary measure, but now it looks a bit more permanent. And I know you've got something to say about that, Ollie, because you've been speaking to the traders down there and other people. And what have they got to say?
Well, I've been using Madeira Drive for a number of years. I know the traders very well. And I was really shocked to hear that it was not going to be reopened to all users because it's discriminating against disabled people who can't access it at the moment. It's going to really damage their businesses. And it's proved to be quite a dangerous place because of the number of accidents involving speeding cyclists and pedestrians. And it's something that is a jewel in the crown of Brighton and should be for all. It should be for cyclists. I cycled here today. Pedestrians, runners, mods, other scooterists, motorcyclists, disabled people, for everybody. It shouldn't be just closed off on the back of coronavirus as part of an anti-car agenda.
Yeah, and the business down there, you think they're going to lose more money than, obviously they've been shut anyway, but they're going to lose even more of their income.
Well, they've had a hell of a kicking financially under coronavirus. And coming out of that, for Madeira Drive to continue to be closed to their main customers, who are mods and other scooter riders, motorcyclists, and people accessing it by car from other towns who wouldn't be able to come to Brighton, couldn't afford to come to Brighton if it wasn't for being able to use their cars, then undoubtedly they're going to suffer enormously. A lot of them will go broke. They're very, very angry about it. They're saying that that the council would be in breach of their contracts if they kept it closed, and they would all be asking for compensation, typically for one restaurant or cafe of £1 million. The compensation claims could be as high as £20 million coming into Brighton and Hove City Council, which is already pretty strapped, cash strapped.
Yeah, there are benefits to it being pedestrianised. So, people saying in yourself, you're saying that it shouldn't ever be pedestrianised, or should it be like a halfway house where maybe it's open during the week, closed at weekends? I mean, is there a solution where both parties can be happy? Because it has been popular as well, hasn't it, the pedestrianisation? From what I've seen, and I go in there every day, it's also people have got a greater space to walk and they can socially distance.
Well, it's a hugely wide and long area. It's about 40 yards wide and it's miles long. There's plenty of space for all. When I've been down there, for instance, I went down last Sunday morning and it was deserted. There was almost nobody there, one or two cyclists, a few pedestrians. Of course, it's a nice place to walk and everybody should respect each other. But at the moment, it's worse than it's ever been because of speeding cyclists, serious accidents with pedestrians. It's not a safe place for pedestrians to go when it's busy. And most of the time, it's empty. So it's clearly not working.
Yeah. So what's the solution then? So you want it, the pedestrianisation ended then and then it brought back to how it was before the coronavirus outbreak?
It needs to be reopened to all users as soon as possible. The traders have said if there is going to be an element of pedestrianisation, then a lot of investment and landscaping needs to take place first. That's vital. There's been historic underinvestment and neglect by councils going back decades of Madeira Drive and the arches, which have been allowed to crumble. They need to be restored as is being planned. But it needs to be considered in the whole as an area of recreation for all.
Yeah. And what about the businesses then? So are they writing to the council? I know you've been speaking to them. I mean, is there anything else they could do? I know there's a protest coming up, aren't there? Certain protests. There could be protests, isn't there?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't want to comment on protests, what might happen. But in terms of the 35 major traders down there, the major businesses, they had a crunch meeting on Monday with the council, and they made it very clear to the council that it needs to reopen without further delay, or they would be asking for their rent back, that they would be asking, they'd be in a situation where they're going to have to make redundancies. And what I find quite disturbing about this whole business is that elements of the hard left have got on board in terms of the anti-car agenda and are actively campaigning nationally using Labour Party email channels to people who have probably never heard of Madeira Drive to try and boost the petition, which is up against our petition to keep it reopened on the council's e-petitions website, to boost the petition falsely of people who want to keep it closed to traffic.
Yeah, okay. And so it's going to be a long-run story, isn't it? We haven't had a final decision from the council yet, have we?
Well,
we think that they want to keep it open, open for pedestrians over the longer term, but there's been no final decision. Is that?
Well, I mean, it's clear from what I've seen in terms of some of the hard left Labour emails that have been going out that the hard left element want to keep it closed indefinitely. I mean, the council's Environment and Transport Committee are considering it. As far as they have told the traders, it's only a temporary closure for the coronavirus crisis. And therefore, once lockdown ends, it should reopen.
Yeah, OK, we'll leave it there, Ollie. Thanks for coming.
Thank you.
Thanks.